It's important because in almost all IT environments, there are thousands of vulnerabilities typically. These vulnerabilities, it's software, that is outdated, that needs to be patched. It can be misconfigurations within applications, cloud infrastructure. And unfortunately, most organizations carry a significant backlog of vulnerabilities. So the question is, what vulnerabilities to fix first? Which ones are actually going to move the needle in terms of reducing risk? That's where the risk-adjusted part of this comes into play, because fixing vulnerabilities takes time. It requires somebody to go do work. What you want, what we want for our customers, is for them to be fixing and addressing the vulnerabilities that maximally reduce risk, of a compromise and a security incident. And by focusing on the risk side, we make sure that we get the kind of most benefit from time spent from the IT team or the MSPs managing the environment. It's also important on the continuous side that we're always looking out for what we call a priority one vulnerability, a vulnerability that is being actively exploited and typically provides remote access. It's a remote access vector. When those come up, remote access vulnerability that's being exploited, we need to get on that fast. On the continuous side of things, what really matters here is being aware of any vulnerability that is being actively exploited, and typically ones that can be done so remotely and can provide immediate access into the environment from which a threat actor can quickly break out and further compromise systems or accounts. When a P1, critical vulnerability emerges, rapid response is required. And there you want to make sure you have the operation in place where that vulnerability can be identified and pushed out to your IT team or MSP to be remedied within hours.